DMK Chief Karunanidhi upset Anton Mulaperiyar, demands that the dam and its catchment areas in Idukki be made part of Tamil Nadu. Says they were annexed by the state of Travancore. Madurai bench of the Madras High Court allows Jallikattu festival to be organized in Tamil Nadu. Asks government to ensure that the Supreme Court recommendations on the festival is implemented. A 40-year-old man is stabbed and crushed to death beyond recognition in Vasarpadi. Investigations are on to nab the culprits. This is the 12th murder in the city in as many days. A new garbage collector begins work in 3 zones of Chennai. The corporation outsources the work to Ramke Enviro. Will segregation of waste happen this time around?
As long as garbage finds its place in the bin, we will have no problem.
Chief Minister Jayalalitha announces the operation of over 5,000... And Vijay star Nanban gets rave reviews. Fans happy that the remake of Three Idiots has been done intelligently by director Shankar. Hello, you're watching Headlines Now with me, Kalisai Mukherjee. Now let's take a quick look at the national headlines. BSP lashes out at the Election Commission for its order to cover statues of Mayawati and elephants. Says the decision is illegal and has hurt the sentiments of the downtrodden. Industrial production for November is up by 5.9% compared to the same period last year. This comes after the slump in October figures. Army Chief General V.K. Singh says the row over his age has vitiated the atmosphere and many have given it a vicious spin. After rats nibble on a patient in ICU in a Jodhpur hospital, authorities move to fix holes in buildings and the caretaker and the nurse on duty are suspended pending inquiry. After 16 long years of intense immunization, India is polio-free and for the first time, the WHO has taken India off the endemic list. Supreme Court hands out a 3-year jail term to Alistair Pereira in a hit-and-run case of 2006 in which 7 people were killed. Pakistan President Asif Ali Zardari leaves for a 1-day trip to Dubai amid growing tension at home between his civilian government and the army. Reports say PMLAQ Chief Chaudhary Shujaat Hussain may be mediating between Jilani and the army chief, even as Imran Khan calls for early elections. MS Dhoni says for him to continue till the 2015 World Cup, he will have to retire from one format of the game, namely Test Cricket. Gone widow Yoko Ono tells NDTV she is not the one to blame for the breakup of the Beatles and that she has been made a scapegoat. Top story on the Mulaperiyar Rao, former Tamil Nadu Chief Minister and DMK leader M. Karunanidhi demanded that the dam structure and its catchment areas should be part of Tamil Nadu. He said Peermedu and Devikulam areas in Idukki district should be given to Tamil Nadu and was wrongly annexed by the British to the state of Travancore, which is now a part of Kerala. Under a decades-old agreement, the 116-year-old dam is being controlled by Tamil Nadu, which uses its water to irrigate its southern districts. The Madras High Court has given permission to conduct Jallikattu, a bull-taming festival popular in South Tamil Nadu. The court has, however, asked the state to ensure implementation of conditions stipulated by the Supreme Court. The order came after Tamil Nadu government assured to ensure safety of bulls and people. The traditional part of Pongal, Jallikattu, had been objected to strongly by animal rights activists, and even the Supreme Court had slammed the Tamil Nadu government for allowing the event to run for 5 months. As per the order, the district collectors have been asked to file affidavits after the event. It's time for all the crime updates across the city in the brand new segment FIR. A man who was about 40 years of age was found murdered this morning in Vyasarpadi. He was found lying in an empty house which was demolished last week. The victim was stabbed and later his face was crushed with stone. The locals noticed a body in the house and immediately informed the local police. The investigations are on to identify the victim and the Vyasarpadi police have registered a case under Section 174. With this, the number of murders in Chennai has gone up to 12 in the new year.
நாங்கெல்லாம் போய் பார்த்தோம். போய் பார்க்கும்போது முகத்தில் நல்ல அடிபட்டுருக்கு, ஒரே பிளட்டாக தான் இருக்குது முகத்தில், இப்படியே படுத்துட்டுருக்கு. அதுக்கப்புறம் போலீஸ் இன்ஃபார்ம் பண்ணுறது 9 மணி ஆகிப்போச்சு. அப்புறம் அவங்க வந்து ஃபோட்டோ எடுத்தாங்க, அப்புறம் ஃபிங்கர் பிரிண்ட்ஸ் மாதிரி இதுதான் கல் எள்ளு மண் எல்லாம் எடுத்தாங்க. மோப்ப நாய் கொண்டு வந்தாங்க. நாயும் போய் இந்த பழனியாண்டூர் கோயிலும் இருக்குது, அது வரைக்கும் போச்சு போய் இன்னும் எடுத்து.
On to the updates from the murder in Kolhatur on Tuesday, where a 37-year-old realtor was hacked to death by a gang in broad daylight. Two people have surrendered at the Kanchipuram court, accepting the responsibility of the murder. Meanwhile, former DMK MLA B. Ranganathan, who is allegedly involved in this murder, is already in Pural prison on land-grabbing charges. Now an FIR has been filed against him and 11 others. Chennai's new conservancy firm, Ramke Enviro Limited, will collect garbage from households and use mechanical sweepers in the three zones it will be taking care of. Every 300 houses in the three zones will be covered by a garbage collector on a tricycle, who will empty three big bins a day. Garbage collectors will also segregate and transport garbage from houses to designated collection areas. The conservancy agency has also submitted a micro plan about its operations in the Thenampet, Kodambakkam and Adyar zones.
With today, we have rolled out the private participation of garbage collection with Ramke as the successful tenderer on this. What they have done is they have started it in 5 wards today. They will then be rolling it out in the rest of the wards in zone 9 from the 18th of this month. By the 30th of this month, all three zones that they have chosen, that they have been successful in, they will be rolling out the garbage collection for all the three zones. Now, they're using many of the regular methodologies with a small change here and there. On the one side, they are going door to door and conducting an awareness campaign with the public, requesting them to cooperate and to segregate the garbage, to separate what can easily go into the dump yard and things that will not easily, which are not biodegradable, like plastics and so on. So we want the public to cooperate with us, every individual home to cooperate with this collection mechanism. And they've also employed a lot of staff. Nearly 3,500 plus people will be deployed in all these three zones. And in addition, a lot of compactor lorries and tricycles and compactor bins. And as long as garbage finds its place in the bin, we will have no problem.
இனிமேல் எப்படி குப்பை எடுக்க வேண்டும் என்கின்ற புதிய நவீனமான ஒரு கண்ணோட்டத்தினை முயற்சியை 141வது வட்டத்திலே நாங்கள் இன்றைக்கு அதை பரிச்சாத்தமாக நடைமுறைப்படுத்தி வருகிறோம். பைலட் புரோகிராம் சென்னை மாநகரத்தில் இனிமேல் இப்பொழுது இருக்கின்ற அந்த நடைமுறையை மாற்றி அமைக்கின்ற வகையில் எங்களுடைய புதிய திட்டம் செயல்பாட்டிற்கு வரும்.
The budget which will be presented in the parliament is just about a month away, and we have decided to air the common man's views on what they want from the budget. Today we decided to ask what the autowala on the street wants from the budget. Here's his request to Pranab Babu on our special segment, Dear Finance Minister.
NDTV, we're running a special segment called Dear Pranab Mukherjee. Here we bring the voice of the common man to the world. As of now, we're here with the auto driver who tells us his view about what are his expectations with the budget.
எங்களுக்கு முதல் போட்ட பட்ஜெட் எங்களுக்கு கிடையாது. பணக்காரங்களே கோடி சொர்ங்க தான். இப்போ பட்ஜெட் தாக்கல் பண்றது ஏழைங்களுக்கு கிரா மாதிரி பட்ஜெட் போட்டா நல்லா இருக்கும். பெட்ரோல் விலையும் ஏறிட்டே இருக்கு. விலைவாசி பயங்கரமா ஏறுது. நடுத்தர வர்க்கம் தான் கஷ்டப்பட்டுக்கணும்.
Hope Mr. Pranab Mukherjee keeps all this in mind while planning the budget. With camera person Madan Deepthi for NDTV Hindu.
They were stripped and paraded naked in Andaman, but is the abuse against the Jarawas tribe just the tip of the iceberg? That's coming up right after this break.